Hi everybody, Andrea Majewski here with Dentalelle. So I want to talk to you guys about some of my go-to products, items that I like to have when I go to patients' homes to clean their teeth. So I'm holding this up now because as silly as it sounds, doesn't this look nice? You know, think of yourself as a patient. You know, after you have your teeth cleaned, or maybe you're not like this, but I always was, it's so nice to get a toothbrush, toothpaste, all of that stuff. And when they put it in a nice bag, I don't know, it just kind of takes your business a step ahead, right? I got these cute bags from smilemakers.com. I love them. I order my kids' toys from there, or I should say toys for the toy box. For my kid patients, I order stickers from there, the bags from there, and certificates. In fact, I just placed an order the other day that I just got the box in. I will do an unboxing afterwards so you guys can kind of see some of the stuff that they do offer. So I love that. I always include about 3 business cards because you never know. They might be talking to their aunt, sister, brother, and oh, somebody comes to your house to clean your teeth. Yes, here's a card. You can contact Andrea. And of course a toothbrush, but I now have the, oh my gosh, what is it called? I have the Curaprox toothbrushes. I had to think about that for a second, but I still have these ordered from before, so I'm using up those first. I prefer the Curaprox toothbrushes because they just look neat. And every time I give them to a patient, they kind of go, oh my God, that's the coolest toothbrush ever. This one's just a normal toothbrush, but I just wanted to show you guys that. Oh, I almost forgot. And I have lip balm for my new patients. So I had gone and ordered a bunch from a small company in Woodstock, Ontario, where I used to live. And you can see my logo on there. And it's just something extra, something nice to give to my new patients. What else do I always have on hand? So I have my go-to toothpastes. Okay, so I'm going to try to hold them with one hand. Here's a couple. There's one more I want to show you guys. There we go. Okay, so these are the toothpastes that I have on hand also if a patient needs something extra. So the Karyo's Zero, that one's for kids who can't have fluoride. There is xylitol in there. It comes in a mint flavor and like a bubble gum, which kids always prefer the bubble gum, but I have the mint as well just in case. The Remin I like to give to patients who have sensitive teeth. So it's like Sensodyne, but it kind of works in a different way where it does also add sheen to the teeth and it covers up any of those like micro pores in the teeth as well. But I do have Sensodyne too because I have some patients where they've been using Sensodyne for 10 years, 5 years, 20 years, whatever. They don't want to use anything else. That's okay. So I do have Sensodyne on hand for them too. These are not sample sizes. So I do charge them the price at cost, but they don't mind because I'm coming to their house. And how often do you recommend a toothpaste or a product to a patient? You tell them to go out and buy it. Usually they're not going to. They want to, they have great intentions, but then when you see them 6 months later, ask if they bought that Listerine mouthwash, oh, I didn't get around to it, I kept forgetting. So at least when I recommend something, I can give it to them. And the fluoride gel right here, that is for those patients that get, you know, 10 cavities every single time. Those patients that need the extra fluoride. I like to use the gel for nursing homes because any of that you're able to introduce back into the tooth, the better. And what I like about this one is that it does also contain xylitol, because if you do the research for the sodium fluoride to be the most effective, it needs to have a xylitol component to first neutralize the pH so your mouth is as healthy as possible for the fluoride to work as effective as possible. So I like how this one has both. What else do I have, you guys? I want to show you a couple little things that I can't live without. My intraoral camera, okay? So I'm actually going to do a video to actually show you guys how well this works. And before I continue, if you guys notice this brown spots there? It's not because it's dirty. It's not because this is how it came. I had got silver diamine fluoride on my camera. I don't know how, but it's amazing how it doesn't show up until afterwards, like maybe a couple minutes. I kind of looked at it like, oh my God, what did I do to my camera? It doesn't come off. Actually, I'm sure it does. I kind of want to ask the company. I get my silver diamine from Oral Science. I want to ask if they have a suggestion how to get the silver diamine off. Okay, so just in case you're wondering. My intraoral camera, you guys, I use on every single patient. Every new patient, I take intraoral photos because it helps for insurance purposes. It helps if they have questions and it helps for comparisons. So when I see them next time, I can compare that amalgam that might be looking a little bit old. Did it look old last time? I don't remember. Look at the intraoral photo. So this is amazing. Another thing that I do that's probably different is a shade guide. I take a shade for every patient. It doesn't matter if they're interested in whitening or not. At some point, once they get comfortable with you, they might say, oh, what do you think of the shade of my teeth? Well, then I can say, well, when I first saw you, your shade was, I don't know, here. Now it's actually a little bit darker. You know, it's now, sorry guys, put that back in there. It's now here. Have you changed your habits? Have you had more coffee, tea lately? So this is really, really helpful. Plus, of course, for the whitening, to take a before and after. I had ordered some notepads from Vistaprint with my logo on it. So that way, if I'm recommending something that I don't have, or I'm telling a patient to use mouthwash before they brush for whatever reason, or a salt water rinse, something like that, I'm going to put that down here just so they remember. But the plus is it has my logo on it. So if they're like, oh yeah, they're talking to their sister, their sister's interested in booking, oh, well, you can contact Andrea. I don't know. Just something that I like to do. Yeah, you guys, I mean, there's other things too, but that's just kind of it in a nutshell. Things you might not necessarily think about. I wanted to show you guys my tray here as well. Don't know how I'm gonna do that without spilling everything. So I kind of had one prepared for you guys. So this is my piezo tip because I like to use a piezo if I can for every patient. My instruments, my amazing polisher, I cannot live without that. I have polish, of course, my saliva ejector, air water syringe, mask, bib, gauze. I always have extra gauze as well because you never know if you need more. So. And don't you love my pink color? I kind of want to get some different colors actually too. I don't know, I like to liven things up a little bit. But, so yeah, you guys, just kind of a random video to show you guys some odds and ends of what I always have. Let me know if there's any questions. Thank you guys for watching and I'll see you very soon.